Welcome to the Slurf Tools tutorial video. In this episode, we'll show you how to use Slurf Tools' market making feature. Through multi-strategy automated trading and batch management of multiple accounts, you can efficiently manage the market value of your tokens and enhance overall market performance. First, open your browser and visit the official Slurf Tools website. In the top right corner, select the language that suits you. Click Market Making to enter this feature page. The market making feature is divided into six sections. One, account overview. Here, you can see all imported accounts, the number of enabled accounts, and a summary of assets related to those accounts, including SOL balance, USDC balance, and the balance of your market making tokens. Two, exchange settings. The exchange settings section is used to choose the trading route and the trading pair you want to manage. Typically, the value token is SOL or USDC, and the market making token is your own project token. Please note that when choosing the trading route, if you have a pump token that's already active on external markets, you should select Raydium. Three, general parameter settings. The general parameter settings section is for configuring global parameters for market making trades, such as the number of trading threads, how many trades to initiate simultaneously, the task execution interval, the time between each trade, slippage settings, usually set to auto, and Jito fee settings to accelerate transactions during on-chain congestion. M4, robot management. The robot management section is the core for operating market making tasks. Currently, it supports three robot strategies. You can configure different parameters for each strategy, start or stop existing strategy tasks, and adjust strategies as needed. A small tip here, you can open multiple market making pages simultaneously, configure different parameters, and run them at the same time. 5. Wallet management. The wallet management section is used to manage your wallet resources. You can import multiple wallets and freely choose which wallets to enable for market making. 6. Transaction log. Finally, the transaction log section. Here you can view the detailed history of each trade, including the transaction time, transaction amount, and transaction hash. You can also see the total counts of successful trades, failed trades, and trades currently in progress. Demonstration, fully automated trading with the market making tool. Importing wallets. First, import the wallets you've already prepared. You can paste the private key or import from a private key file. If you haven't prepared multiple wallets yet, no problem. On the Slurf Tools website, you can open the multi-sender feature to quickly generate multiple wallets. The generated wallet files can be directly imported into market making. Then, use the one-to-many feature in multi-sender to quickly fund each wallet. To avoid linking your funds together, you can then use the many-to-many feature to perform transfers that prevent bubble chart detection. You can do multiple many-to-many transfers to make your fund sources more difficult to trace. After preparing the addresses, return to the market making page and import the wallets you just generated. Once multiple wallets are imported, select the ones you want to use for trading. Account overview will display the relevant data for the selected accounts, making it easier to view and manage them. Exchange settings. In exchange settings, choose the trading pair you want for market making. Typically, your value token is SOL, and your market making token is the project token you issued. You can search by token symbol or contract address. The contract address is recommended to ensure a unique result. After connecting your wallet, you can quickly select tokens that are already in your wallet. Next, choose the trading route. If your token was issued on Pump and is still only on its internal exchange, not yet listed on Raydium, select Pump. If you created the token yourself and set up liquidity on Raydium, choose Raydium. Similarly, if the token started on Pump but is now also listed on Raydium, choose Raydium as well. General parameter settings. Next, we will configure the general parameter settings, which are extremely important. One, the number of trading threads determines how many wallet transactions can run simultaneously. We recommend setting it to 1 to increase the success rate of trades. 2, the task execution interval is the time gap between each wallet initiating a trade. A minimum of 3 seconds is recommended to avoid network congestion. 3, the slippage setting is used to protect your trades from price volatility. you can choose automatic slippage or manually enter a slippage value. Generally, the automatic option is sufficient. 4. The JITO EVM fee is used to set the on-chain priority of a transaction. You can set it to 0 for a standard transaction route or pay additional fees to increase transaction priority. Several quick options are provided, and you can also customize the JITO fee. Robot management. The robot management section contains the most crucial parameters for controlling trades. There's nothing more important. Currently, 3 strategy bots are supported. 1, target pull-up. Set the price you want your market-making token to reach and other parameters. The bot will continuously buy, consuming SOL. 2, target drop. Set the price you want your market-making token to drop to and other parameters. The bot will continuously sell, consuming tokens. 3, traffic bot. Set the range for the token amount in each trade. The bot will continuously buy and sell, increasing overall project activity. Configuring a target pull-up bot. 1. If you want to keep buying, you can set a relatively high target price. 2. Running time refers to the maximum duration the bot operates once started. When the set time is reached, it automatically stops. You can also stop it at any time. 3. Then specify how much SOL to buy per trade. 4. Lastly, set the cumulative maximum trading amount. This is a risk control parameter similar to running time. Once the total amount of SOL purchased reaches this threshold, the bot automatically stops. You can also stop it at any time. Configuring a target drop bot. 1. Target price. The price at which the market-making token stops running once it has dropped to that level. 2. Running time. The maximum duration for which the bot operates after being activated. 3. Single trade amount. The amount of market-making tokens to sell in each trade. You can set a range random or a fixed value. 4. Cumulative maximum trading amount. The difference between target drop and target pull up is that one continuously buys with SOL, while the other continuously sells tokens. The rest of the parameters follow the same logic. Traffic bot. The third bot is the traffic bot. Unlike target pull up, continuous buying, and target drop, continuous selling, the traffic bot allows you to set the token amount for each trade, continuously buying and selling to boost project activity and make the K-line chart look more robust. 1. Single trade volume, the number of tokens traded each time. 2. Cumulative maximum traded tokens. 3. Cumulative maximum traded SOL. 4. Total running time. After completing the configuration, we can choose any robot to start automated trading. In the address list, you can view each address's number of successful and failed transactions, as well as check each transaction's details and the cumulative number of trades in the transaction log. Meanwhile, you can open market analysis tools to monitor relevant token data and better oversee your trading results. During the operation of each robot strategy, you can also switch between different robots to change your trading strategy. Alternatively, you can open multiple market-making pages and import the same or different wallets to run multiple trading robots simultaneously, further increasing trading activity. You can also combine different strategy robots and different parameter settings, making your trades more realistic and natural. For example, in the target pull-up bot, set the task execution interval to 3 seconds, and in the target drop bot, set it to 5 seconds. This way, buy and sell orders will alternate, and there will be more buy orders than sell orders. Thank you for watching. If you encounter any issues during this process, feel free to leave a comment below the video or visit the Slurf Tools Help Center for more detailed tutorials. We will demonstrate other related features in future episodes. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. More practical tutorials will continue to be released. See you next time.